Following 3 years of planning and construction, the new Bell Museum is getting ready to share thousands of years of Minnesota history.
I think that there are some elements that people will remember and see some old familiar favorites, but yes, everything is sort of reinterpreted in a new way.
After outgrowing its old location in Minneapolis, the new building will feature 60% more public space. This museum doesn't do dinosaurs, though there is a polar bear waiting for a home. Instead, the Bell takes visitors step by step through Minnesota's natural history, from a recreation of the Ice Age to lifelike dioramas of Minnesota's different biomes, meticulously moved from the old museum and recreated.
I was just blown away by the restored dioramas. They're exquisite works of art. They're being interpreted in sort of this 21st century way, unlike any other museum in the world does.
The new Bell's other big feature takes visitors out of Minnesota and into the stars with a 120-seat state-of-the-art planetarium. But perhaps most important to the museum is the Bell's ties to education and learning.
What makes the Bell Museum really outstanding and it's going to set itself apart is the fact that we are connected to the University of Minnesota. We're really proud of that, and we really see ourselves as a gateway to all the sciences at the university.
Grand opening weekend is set for July 13th through 15th, but kids will get to experience the museum first during summer camps in June.
We think that every single person in the cities, in the state, in the nation, in the world can find something exciting here at the Bell.
In Falcon Heights, Jeremiah Jacobson, Care 11 News.